Would you like to make more money in 2020? Well, in today's video, I'm so excited because I'm talking all about how to get more money this year. Watch this video to the end to learn 5 steps to attracting money with just your mind. Mind blowing. Hi, welcome to my channel. My name is Jo Randolph and I'm a personal branding consultant and I help women find and get their dream job and build careers they love. If you want to watch videos like this, come and join us and subscribe. I post new videos every single week. So today we're going to talk about money. Money is one of those things that I kind of feel like you just don't talk about with people. You don't ask people how much they make. You don't really know how people are making their money. And it's also difficult to talk about how much money you have. Maybe you're one of those people that kind of avoids looking at your bank account. Money is just a topic that can feel so frustrating unless you feel abundant. Well, in this video, I'm going to share ways you can feel abundant and you can actually create abundance in your life. Let's talk about 5 things you can do to attract more money in 2020. The first thing to do is to identify what is blocking you from making more money this year. If you don't do this first step, it's going to be really difficult for all the others to work. I want you to consider that you right now are blocking yourself from making money. What? When I first heard this concept, I was like, no way. I'm working hard. I know what I want. I know I deserve more money. Give me the money. And it still wasn't appearing until I realized sometimes we unintentionally sabotage ourselves when we want to make money. So I'm just going to give you an example. Imagine someone who had been cheated on so badly by one boyfriend after the other. And eventually she turns 30, 35, whatever, and she is just hurt. She does not believe that men are faithful. She's now created this story in her mind, which she believes is 100% true, because all of the boyfriends in the past have cheated on her. She believes all men cheat. And for that reason, she feels this distrust, this anger, this resentment, and this inability to really connect and give herself completely in a relationship. So what's the impact of that? Well, the impact of that perception and that belief that no man is trustworthy, and the impact of her feeling this anger and frustration and distrust, means that in every relationship that she has, so long as she has this belief, she'll have a really hard time forming intimate, close, and trusting relationships. She will assume and believe that men can't be trusted. And so she won't actually be able to find a man that is trustworthy, because she'll never even give herself the chance or give the man the chance to show they're trustworthy. She'll kind of have crossed them off before the relationship begins. However, if you have another woman who has been through the exact same experience and she says, you know what? I have made the wrong choices in men. I have chosen guys that are just downright poopers and they don't treat women right. And you know what? From now on, I am only going to attract and find a man who is good to me, who is faithful. Basically, she is going to do a Sierra. Now, if any of you follow Sierra, you know, you'll know the joke about how many of us wonder what prayers did Sierra make, because she was able to transform her situation from future, who really wasn't the future at all, into Russell Wilson, who seems to be an amazing husband and an amazing father to 2 of her children. The point is that by saying, you know what, this was in the past, and I know that there is a trustworthy, amazing man out there, and genuinely believing that, you are actually open to finding that person. You allow that person to enter into your life and you allow yourself to be your best self in your relationship so that that trusting, loving relationship can form. Well, it's the same thing with money. Whatever past or history you've developed with money, maybe you haven't always had money. Maybe money has been difficult to get, or maybe money has come, but it has also gone really fast. Or maybe you've had experiences that have made you feel like money is hard to get. If you have that perception and you believe that and you feel frustrated, then that is going to block you from essentially allowing money to enter and flow easily into your life. The first and most important step is to identify what your money beliefs are. Work on essentially replacing those beliefs with beliefs that are empowering, such as money flows easily and effortlessly into my life. I can do something I'm passionate about and make money. And then the next step is to set a goal for what you want to make and really get clear on how much money do you want to make. And don't be shy. It's very easy to kind of want to say something low because you don't feel good about saying a higher number. But if you could attract any amount of money in your life, like any amount, why choose to earn less when you could earn more? That makes no sense. So set a goal for what you would genuinely love. And once you've set that goal, be open to creativity, be open to the universe allowing this money to come to you in ways that you've never expected. Try not to be strict with yourself and say, oh, this money has to come from my job, or this money has to come from this one opportunity. Because if you limit how you'll make money, it makes it really difficult to make more money and attract more money into your life. So the next step is to then don't just wish for it, also believe it and work for it. One of the things that I find so funny is that we wish that we could just think it and it would come. That if we just think about making $1 million somehow falls into our bank account and we're like, wow, that was amazing. I've got like magical manifestation powers. But in reality, it doesn't quite work that way. Like, have you ever thought about manifesting money or anything else? And then maybe you've bought a book, you've done something else, you've watched future videos, and then you try this manifestation stuff and it doesn't happen. And you're waiting like a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, and you're thinking, oh my gosh, I haven't manifested what I wanted. And then you start getting discouraged. And once you start getting discouraged, you think this isn't true, this isn't gonna happen, and you're just not gonna make this kind of money or hit the goals that you want. Well, here's the thing. The way that manifestation works is that it's not enough to simply visualize and to state what you want. You also have to believe that it is going to happen. Your feelings actually accelerate you getting what you want. Now, the beauty of the law of attraction is that if you think something and you believe it, then you attract it. And the downside is that that also works for negative stuff. So if you think you're not gonna make money and you really believe you're not gonna make money, then you're going to definitely not make money. So this law of attraction, it works whether you're thinking about it or whether you're not. It's kind of like gravity. Like, you don't have to think about gravity in order for it to work. You know, you're not gonna suddenly stop thinking that gravity works and then all of a sudden you're gonna, I don't know, float and rise to the moon. You always have the choice of choosing something positive or something negative. So if you believe it's gonna be possible and if you believe it's gonna happen and you visualize and you believe, then it is more likely to happen. But if you allow yourself to get discouraged and you allow yourself to believe it's not gonna happen, then it's not gonna happen and then you'll kind of stay stuck. So that's really important. Now, an easy way that I like to think about it is to think about love. There's a difference between someone saying, I love you, and not meaning it, and someone saying, I love you, and meaning it. And the difference, the impact of this difference is so large that it's literally life-changing. If someone was to say, I love you, and not mean it, you probably wouldn't date them, you probably wouldn't marry them, you probably wouldn't have children with them. But if someone was to say, I love you, and they really meant it, and if you loved them back, and you really felt in love, deeply in love with this person, that's life-changing. Like, love is life-changing. You could get married, and if you don't get married, you could buy a house, you could have children, you could spend the rest of your life with this person. That is completely life-changing. So what I'm trying to say is that whatever you wish for, mean it with love and affection, and that will really help to change your life in the finance arena of your life. And then the next thing to do is to work for it. Allow your mind to see and spot the opportunities. So once you've stated, I want to make X amount every month, and you really believe it, then allow your mind to see the opportunities and take those opportunities. Try not to talk yourself out of things. So I'll give you an example. I have a baby and I stay at home with my daughter every day. So I found it quite difficult to find a way to grow my business, to grow my income whilst being a mom and being a wife and really trying to do well in those areas of my life too. And so I knew that I need to figure out a way. But before, I used to have beliefs that, like, you have to work full time to make money, you have to have a proper job, or you have to have a really successful business, you have to have a big team to make money. And I was stuck. So I was thinking, I don't have a big team, I don't have a full time job, I can't work full time hours. How am I going to do this? Those are my limiting beliefs and, you know, my limiting beliefs around money. But then I realized I have to believe it. I have to believe it's possible for me to make money, even as a mom who's staying at home. And I just have to believe it's possible. So here's what I did. I have been working on manifestation stuff for a while, and I'll share some resources a bit later that I've used. And I said to myself, okay, I want to make more money, and I want the money to come to me easily and effortlessly. Money is flowing into my life easily and effortlessly. And I set goals, and I was open to the money coming in ways that I'd never expected. Well, here's the thing. Literally within 2 days, I got an email from someone who had been watching my videos, and they gave me a consulting opportunity to help them create a program for organizations across the UK. So this was like a huge opportunity for me, and it also meant that I got a new check, and I was able to get this check within like a month. And then I started getting contacted from other people who were working with companies who were also wanting my advice on how to help women progress in the workplace. So I started realizing, huh, this money is coming. And I then started to get more commissions, all these kind of affiliate sales just coming in. And then I started to get more sales in my business. And all of this happened without me doing anything new. I didn't do any advertising. I didn't do anything new. The only thing I did was allow myself to be open and to receive whatever opportunities that came my way. So when an opportunity came up, I said yes. When something came up, I said yes. And that's what helped me to increase my income literally within days. And then last but not least, it's to thank the universe and thank God when money comes in. It doesn't matter what type of money that comes in, whether you find a penny on the floor, whether you find 10 pounds or 20 pounds or 100 pounds, whatever, in your wallet, whether you find inheritance money that you didn't exist, know existed, whether you actually get paid for a job, whether you have money that's coming but it's in transit, maybe you'll get paid at the end of the month, whatever shape or form, gift cards, vouchers, whatever gift or form that money comes in, thank the universe, thank God, say thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, and acknowledge it. Because when you acknowledge the money that's coming in, it makes you feel abundant. And you're also telling God and the universe that I am grateful for all the money you're giving me. Please give me more. And it gives you more. In terms of resources, one person I definitely recommend is Denise Duffield Thomas. She has a book which is all about how to attract more money. And her book is amazing. I would love to know, why would you like to attract more money into your life? Leave a comment in the box below. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I can't wait to see you again next week. All right, bye.
Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for new videos, and click the bell button in order to get notified whenever I post new videos. There are so many more videos you can watch right now, so click on the video on the left or the right or the left or the right. I can't wait to see you next week.